background pun dah background.
Eh, dah masuk lah.
Hi student. Do you hear me?
Assalamualaikum, Cica.
Salam. Do you hear me? Yes. Can everybody hear my voice? If yes, please show me thumbs up. Kalau dengar, tunjuk thumbs up, please. Tak dengar ke Ilham?
Hmm?
Dengar ke Cucu Tani ni?
Ya. Tak dengar sangat.
Cucu cakap kalau dengar suara teacher, tunjuk thumbs up.
Ah, okay.
Okay, so everybody can hear my voice. Where's our class monitor? Where's our class monitor?
Kat Braga.
Okay. Okay. So, as usual lah. Stand up, student. I think Ilham cannot hear my voice, I think. Ilham?
Yeah?
You ask your friend to stand up. You stand up.
Stand up. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, teacher.
Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, teacher.
Waalaikumsalam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Let's istighfar and salawat 3 times.
Astaghfirullah
al-azim
Lawat dah. Doa.
Allahumma
salli ala sadari wa yasirli amri wa dhul katami lisani yafqahu qawli rabbi zidni
ilman wa zidni faman amin ya rabbal alamin amin
amin ya rabbal alamin. How are you, student?
I'm fine, alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah. Okay, we meet again for Islam subject. Kim, before we start our class, teacher want to share with you about hadith for this week. What the hadith? What this week, student?
The sweetness, delight of faith.
Yes, good. The sweetness or delight of faith. Faith ni maksudnya iman. Iman. Okay. Okay, so okay, I read read this hadith again. Then you listen to this hadith, okay? Dan Anas An-Nabi qala salasu man kana fihi wajada bihinna halawatul iman. Okay, halawatul iman ni maksudnya ke halawah, manis. Halwa, sweetness. Kemanisan iman, man kana Allah wa rasuluhu ahabba ilaihi mimma sawahuma wa an yuhibbu al-mara'i la yuhibbuhu ila Allah wa anna yakrahu an ya'uda fi al-kafari ba'da an akazahu Allah. Allahu minhu kama yakrahu an yakazafa finnar. Rawahu al-Bukhari wal-Muslim wa ghairihima. Okay, riwayat al-Bukhari wal-Muslim dan beberapa lagi. It is reported on the authority of Anas from the Messenger of Allah, which is Prophet Muhammad, that is said that there are three qualities. Whoever is characterized by that will taste the sweetness of iman. Okay. Sesiapa yang mempunyai ciri-ciri mendapat kemanisan iman, one to whom Allah and His Messenger are dearer than all else. Maksudnya, sesiapa yang dekat dengan Allah, dengan Nabi Muhammad. And one who love a man only for Allah's sake. Seseorang yang suka atau sayang kepada people, okay, umat manusia, orang Muslim, because of Allah. Again, and who dog, whoever returning to this belief after Allah has rescued him from his fate, who has been cast into the hell. Okay, dan dia menjauhkan diri daripada disbeliever, orang yang tidak percaya kepada Allah. So, the narrator ni, orang yang menyampaikan hadis ni namanya Anas Ibn Malik Ibn Nadar Al-Khazraj Al-Ansari. Okay, who is he? Actually, he is a well-known sahabi. When teacher state that sahabi means sahabat, the companion, the sahabat of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He was Ansar of the Banu Khazraj. Okay, nama dia punya kaum Banu Khazraj. Anas Ibn Malik ni, dia ni sangat well known lah. Okay. Dia sangat well known, terkenal pada zaman because the last of the companion of the Prophet died at the Basra. Dia meninggal dia pada 63 Hijrah pada umur 103. So, dia adalah antara yang the narrator of this hadith. So, I hope, okay, for lesson you get from this hadith is, number one is the characteristic of true believer. Ciri-ciri orang yang benar-benar beriman kepada Allah. A true characteristic of true believer. Okay. Then our love of Allah and His Messenger are part of iman. Is that our love towards Allah and His Messenger adalah salah satu sifat orang yang beriman. Loving one's Muslim brother and only for Allah's sake is a part of iman. If we love our brother or sister, okay, Muslim people, because of the sake of Allah, it's also is part of iman, half of our iman. Then, hate to return to this place as part of faith. Okay, if you hate someone who disbelief in Allah, maksudnya kat sini dia tak percaya kepada Allah, okay, it's also one part of iman. Understand? If yes, please show me thumbs up. Okay, now let's proceed with our lesson. Okay, for Islam subject today, we're going to learn about under the theme of Sin, What a Wonderful World. Okay, What a Wonderful World. But today, we're going to learn about the layer of the earth. The layer of the earth.
Tak, nak guna PowerPoint lah.
I know. Today, I want you to do, you take the Islam book.
Islam book tu mana satu, teacher?
Book number one, don't forget.
Layar saya tak ada Islam book lagi.
Why?
Mak saya belum ambil.
Okay, those who not take your book, go and take any paper. Okay, today is what? Okay, Wednesday. Please write down the date and the day. Today is 24 of February 2021. Okay, so if you write down this, okay, before that, teacher will explain to you what's the layer of the earth first before we go more. Wait for a while. Okay, actually the layer, the composition of the earth, there is a few composition of the earth. Okay, I will show this one first. Okay, we look at this note first. Okay, the composition of the earth, actually same with the layer also, it may seem like the earth. You imagine that it's made up of a big solid rock, but it's really made up of a number of parts. Okay. And then it is constantly moving. Okay. You imagine ada satu bentuk big rock, solid big rock. You know, rock is batu. Yes. And then it's moving. It's moving. It's constantly moving. You imagine that, okay, I don't have a globe, but just imagine that this is the earth, the rock, then it's moving. Then you can think that, okay, you also can imagine onion. Okay, the layers like an onion. You know what is onion?
Yes.
You tengok bawang tu, dia ada layer dia. So this layer get more and more dense the closer to earth you get. Okay. Okay, this picture, you may see that there is four main layer of the earth. Okay, the first layer, which is the outside of the earth, is named as what? Crust.
Crust.
Yes, crust. Did it? Okay, it is outside of the earth. Okay, the onion, and it is outside of the earth. Then, after the, in the middle, the name is mantle. Man?
Mantle.
A-M-A-M-T-L-E. Okay.
Mantle.
Dalam mantle tu lagi, ada lagi layer dia, nama dia what? Outer core. Ni dalam perut bumi, eh. You imagine that perut bumi. Okay, then dalam outer core, ada lagi satu layer yang nama dia inner core. Okay, crust, mantle, outer and inner core. Okay, then teacher will explain a little bit more about the crust. What is the crust is all about? Okay, the crust is the thin outer layer of the earth where we live. Okay, where is the thin on the picture, and it is the thin relative to other layers. But don't worry, we're not going to fall through by accident anytime. The crust is varies from around 5 kilometers thick in the ocean floor and to around 70 kilometers thick on the land where we live, called continental crust. Then the continental crust is made of rock that is consists of primary silica and aluminum called the style. Okay, so student, okay, so dia lapisan paling bumi yang paling nipis. Tapi even dia paling nipis, Masya Allah, because Allah has create the earth in the very perfect condition. Even paling nipis pun tak ada siapa-siapa pun jatuh kalau berjalan. Betul tak? That's why. Then layer number two is called mantle. Okay, the next layer of the earth is called mantle. Actually mantle ni dia lagi tebal, dia lagi thicker than the crust. Dia lebih kurang dalam 3000 km deep. Okay. So mantle ni is made out of slightly different silicate rocks with more magnesium and iron. Dalam mantle tu, you imagine that dalam tu, kalau rock kan, rock, silicate rock, dia ada magnesium, dia ada iron. Okay, yang tu tak apa. Yang tu nanti you up level, you belajar lah what is magnesium, what is iron. But right now, teacher just want to...
Kita tahu.
You know. You know. You already know. Sebab, siapa tahu tu? Okay, apa yang you tahu pasal magnesium and iron?
Diorang tahu pasal Iron Man.
Pasal apa?
Ilham cakap diorang tahu pasal Iron Man.
Iron Man is different. They want to be not the Iron Man outside the earth. You all need to listen to me first. Okay, then tectonic plates. Okay. Tectonic plate ni dia combination of the crust and outer mantle. Okay, kita panggil dia juga sebagai lithosphere. Maybe dia duduk kat sini lah ni. Dia duduk kat sini. Ni. Dia duduk antara crust dengan mantle ni. Okay. And then, what else? These plates, they move very slowly around couple of inch of a year. Okay, dia berpusing eh. Bumi kita berpusing. Tapi kita tak rasa pun bumi kita berpusing kan. Then, where the plate touch each other is called fault. When the plate move and the boundaries bump against each other, it can cause an earthquake. Okay, actually earthquake, do you tahu earthquake?
Yes.
Gempa bumi. Okay, gempa bumi yang berlaku dekat dekat mana? Dekat Indonesia. Dekat outside of our country. Okay, because of the movement between the boundaries bump again tadilah yang teacher cakap tu nama dia fault tadi tu. Okay, dia duduk macam you tengok eh, you tengok gambar gempa bumi ni. Ada lagi kat dekat mana? Dekat sini.
No.
Tapi itu kalau berlaku lah. But I don't want to go more detail of
that. Itu lukis lah.
No, wait for a while. Which one ya? Sekejap. Okay, but you know is gempa bumi tu macam mana kan? You tahu kan?
Tahu.
Tahu, tapi saya tu.
Okay, tapi ya, ni lagi tak ada lagi gempa bumi. Okay, so we'll go. Okay, kita pergi lagi. Apa lagi yang kita kena tahu? Okay, dalam teknon ni, maksudnya kalau gempa bumi tu berlaku antara crust dengan mantle, dia ada kat sini namanya tectonic plate. Bila plate ni berlanggar, sebab itulah berlakunya gempa bumi. And then you go there, kita pergi dekat outer core. Yeah. Outer core ni the layer yang here.
Kalau gempa kan. Nanti kan tectonic plate tu dia tu kan. Kenapa dekat satu tempat je? Kan dekat bumi. Kenapa dekat satu tempat je?
Bukan satu bumi. Masa tu teknoplate dia tu hanya berlaku pelanggaran kat tempat tu je. Kalau lah berlaku semua pelanggaran, dah kiamat dah kita. Betul tak? Maksudnya masa tu teknoplate tu ada movement, dia berlaku pelanggaran kat situ. That's why. Contoh yang paling dekat kita, kalau dekat Indonesia lah. So masa tu berlaku pelanggaran dekat tempat tu sahaja. Jadi ada area sekitar yang tu yang efek. Kalau tempat lain tu dia tak efek lah. Okay. Then we move to outer core. Outer core ni second layer. Second layer dalam perut bumi. Inner core, outer core. Okay. Outer core ni is made of iron and nickel. Iron ni besi lah. Dia sangat panas. Dia lebih kurang 4,400 to 5,000 degrees Celsius. So, it's so hot. Sangat-sangatlah panas that the iron and nickel metal are liquid. Tapi iron dia dibentuk liquid tau. Kalau kita pernah tengok iron besi, tak liquid kan? Dia metal, dia, tapi ni macam cair. Maksudnya gegak lah kat situ, memang betul-betul panas lah. Tapi kita tak rasa lah benda, benda tu kan, kita duduk kat luar. Kita duduk dekat surface kat ni. Then the outer core is very important to Earth. Why? Ada magnetic field, they create magnetic field. Okay, magnetic field ni adalah outer core that create goes way out in the space and make a protective barrier around the Earth that shield Earth from the sun, damaging the solar wind. Dia penting lah untuk kita ada magnetic field ni, magnetic field. Magnetic field ni dia nanti belajar nanti. Yes?
Macam mana scientist boleh tahu semua benda ni?
Dia buat research lah, dia buat research. Of course, scientist do the research for this one.
Dia ada theory.
Yeah, this is for your theory. And then the inner core yang paling dalam, inner core pun ada iron and nickel juga. Just like the outer core. Tapi inner core ni dia different sikit. Yep. Inner core is so deep within the earth and under immense pressure. So, dia pressure dia so hot but it is solid. Awak bayangkan dia panas tapi dia dalam bentuk solid. Dia perut bumi yang paling dalam, dia dalam bentuk solid. Tapi kalau inner core tadi dia bentuk, outer core tadi bentuk liquid. So inner core is the hottest part of the earth and it over 5000 degrees Celsius. It's so hot and it's about as hot as the surface of the sun. Nak cakap dia sangat panas, dibayangkan dia ibarat macam matahari ada kat luar dia dan you duduk kat situ. Panas tak panas?
Panas?
Dia lah, dia kiranya dia lapisan layer yang paling panas. Okay. So student, so you have to know, go and take your Islam book now. Teacher want you to take this note for you. You have to take this note.
Teacher, saya tak ada Islam book teacher.
Kenapa tak ada lagi? Tak dapat lagi.
Coklat ke teacher?
Sorry?
Buku coklat ke teacher?
Yes, book number one.
Saya tak.
Ramai lagi yang tak ambil. Nanti you ambil eh.
Ada ke dekat sekolah sekarang ni?
Nombor 8 dah ada, nombor 1 tak sure. Nanti teacher tanya kelas teacher kamu.
Ya, okay. Ini semua yang bumi ni, dalam bumi ni ke nak kena salin yang ayat yang banyak ni?
Okay, teacher want you to take the, sekejap ya, teacher nak suruh you buat simplify. You draw in your book, you take the note. The note ni pun important juga untuk you all semua.
Tapi teacher, saya tak ada buku lah.
I'll go and take any paper, A4 paper.
Okay, jom. Apa?
Do you mana have it? Kena? If yes, do you have it? Ilham?
Yes, yes. Ni kertas ada.
Mana? Okay. Okay, I want you to take this. No, the layer.
Mana satu teacher? Okay,
you can take this note. Okay, it is more simplified. You draw the lapisan bumi, the mantle, the inner core, yeah, inner core, mantle, crust, outer core tu semua. Eh, janganlah you want to take screen teacher. Apalah you all semua. So, you do this one first. Ke you nak ambil terus nota tu?
Minta teacher kena tulis.
Sekejap. Siapa yang main-main dengan I punya skill ni?
Tak, itu saya lukis.
Oh, ingatkan saya saja tadi. Sekejap. So, sekejap ya. Nak ambil apa tadi? Okay. You nak tulis, ambil yang teacher tulis kat sini ke macam mana? Yang teacher sebut tadi ke atau yang lukis tadi?
Lukis
Lukis.
Lukis.
Ramai lah lukis. Sebab tu lagi simplify, lagi senang kan. Okay, I give you time to write in your book. In your book number one. If you don't have book, okay, you do write in any paper. We have to know the layer of the earth. Remember, we have four layer: the outer, the paling luar, namanya crust, outside of the layer earth, and then the dia meliputi like ocean, kan, and etc. Kat luar-luar lah, lebih sama bumi-bumi yang kat luar, ocean, mountain, kan?
Ya.
Yes.
Orang kan dia selalu macam dikata apa kan?
Dia apa?
Dia macam orang dia selalu nak eksperimen kan? Dia macam ada di kan? Guna pentah kan?
Tak dengar apa?
Kalau orang sometimes dia macam dig. Teacher tahu dig? Dia dig dekat sini. Kalau macam orang dig, dia macam ni je kan?
Deep. Oh, berenang. Apa yang
tu, macam dia turun bawah guna shovel. Okay.
Dia turun bawah, lepas tu dia sampai mana? Oh, dia takkan sampai perut bumi. Kalau dia pergi inner core ataupun outer core, impossible. Sebab dia kerak bumi yang paling dalam.
So kalau 4000 feet, dia dekat sini je. Toing-toing.
Dia lapisan yang paling tu je. Dia sangat tak adalah lagi siapa yang boleh masuk kerak bumi ya.
Kalau mental boleh tak masuk?
No. I think no.
Maybe. Bahkan bila turun tanah pun dah panas.
Actually the mantle is where lava and volcano come from. From the mantle. Yeah.
Betul. Sure. Mula ke buat kat bawah pun.
Kat bawah mana?
Dia cakap boleh tak buat dekat PowerPoint. Ya. Yeah.
Oh, nak buat kat PowerPoint. Siapa nak buat kat PowerPoint tu?
Ramai orang. Pak Izari.
Nak buat kat PowerPoint. Lepas tu nak submit dekat I. Pun boleh.
Cuma senang kan, tak payah nak ambil gambar.
Actually teacher want you to take the note that I provide to you, because after this we will have what we call the earth layer. Siapa dah buat the earth layer ni? Teacher ada, after you take this note, we have quiz you have to answer. Sekejap ya.
Apa? I can do for quiz.
You buat dulu. Just nak buka the earth layer yang teacher. Is it another acting that?
Kita kena lukis dengan tulis ke teacher? Penat lah saya boleh tulis atau lukis je.
Kenapa?
Alah, penat tak saya ni.
Penat? Biasalah nak belajar.
Ya, dah susah balik.
Dia depends. You kalau you tak nak buat pakai, ada your friend request to use the PowerPoint, I allow lah them. Kalau you tak nak, you lukis je lah macam biasa. You buat je lah dekat buku you. Buku nombor satu tu.
So kena lukis dengan tulis?
Yeah, you kena lukis. Tu layer tu you kena tahu.
Lukis
bulat je pun.
Okay. Mana ni? Tapi tu kecil sangat. Okay, buat je lah bulat macam saya nak. Haha. Okay, tak boleh lah. Yalah. Semua ke? Entah.
Okay, teacher, saya nak color.
Lukis dah. Anda ni
Okay, siapa yang tak nak buat kat PowerPoint boleh buat dekat buku and then color. Rauda dia nak color. Okay, sure, boleh. Okay, you buat dulu. I give you time to write. Bapak masuk.
Teacher Zuba ya. Zuba dia makan.
Carbohydrate.
Dia makan tadi.
Dia biasa internet dia slow cakap. Dah, ini pelambat.
Saya mandi.
Apa? What?
Tadi kita buat makan sampai lambat.
Okay, continue. We have to write down the notes for the layer of the earth or the component.
Kena buat apa?
Salin ni.
Okay.
Kena buat, you have to copy, you have to, sorry. Okay, you have to write in your book or your friend request to do in the PowerPoint this component of the earth or the layer of the earth.
Saya buat shining kat bawah pun.
Siapa tu? Ari ke?
Mm-mm.
Buat mana? Tengok sikit.
Share?
Haa, cuba share. Eh, Anik ada tak Anik?
Teacher tengok share je.
Tak. Ari, Anik datang tak?
Anik ada.
Anik? Oh, Anik. Kenapa hitam je tu? Kenapa dia punya mana tuannya? Anik, janganlah tu kamera. I mute sekejap. Mai cantik. Tengok sikit.
Oh, kena buat tu.
Okay. Let me see. But siapa tu? Hari, teacher nak you buat description sikit. What's all the mantles about? Is the octopus is about? Tak nak lah macam ni je. Kena tambah sikit. Faham tak? Like yeah. I do for... You dah buat dah lah. What dah? Kena tambah sikit ni.
Teacher, mana that, screen teacher?
Sekejap lah. I like I do in my...
Nanti saya ambil gambar. So, itu terus kat PowerPoint.
Like that. Okay, I want you to do like this. Where's the inner core?
Teacher, teacher.
Yes.
Teacher dah buat folder untuk ini.
Sorry?
Teacher dah buat folder.
Oh, not yet. Yeah. Okay, I made a folder. I assign the folder in Google Classroom. Then you submit the thing.
Okay.
Actually, I want... Okay, tak apa. You buat yang ni dulu. Everybody okay?
Yes.
If you want to ask anything or you have any problem, you may tell me. Saya kena buat PowerPoint ke, ya. Ataupun tulis dalam buku nombor 1. Nombor
siapa tak ada buku tu, tak kertas kan?
Macam tu, slide teacher.
Haa, tak ada buku buat kat kertas. Apa kita punya tajuk tadi? Component of the earth.
You bukan layers of the earth ke?
Sama je. Layer dengan component. Same.
Okay.
Okay. Let's break this one. Dah siap ke Muiz?
Belum.
Saya dah buat macam texture.
Finish? You want to share with me, your friends, your
slides? Yeah. Boleh je.
Okay, Ari. Okay, I already assigned this work at the Google Classroom. Teacher Zoom in tak nampak apa dia tulis. Yang mana? Dia orang dah ada ni siap-siap tu. Wait, wait, sekejap eh. Explain a little bit more.
Terbalik tempat.
You understand what?
Layer of Earth by Ari.
Okay, then?
Rust mental outer core, inner core.
Yeah.
Facts about layer of Earth. Crust or lithosphere. The Earth's crust, which includes landforms, rocks, and soil, it is mostly solid rock, is rigid and has high strength in various in thickness, from as little as 5 km under the ocean to about 70 km under mountain ranges like the Himalayas.
Do you understand this?
Sikit lah.
Okay, this one is like I said previously. Dia, kalau dia ocean, ocean tu lapisan yang paling luar lah eh. Luar dekat perut bumi. Dekat bumi.
Tak tertekan.
Mana slide Asia?
Outer core, molten iron and nickel temperature mostly between 4,000 Celsius and 6,000 Celsius, about 2,300 km thick. Hydrosphere, the water on or at the surface of the Earth, including oceans, lakes, rivers, and rain and mist. Inner core, mostly iron solid, owing to the extreme pressure temperatures up to 7,000 Celsius, about 1,200 km thick. Atmosphere, a blanket of gases that surround the Earth to height of approximately 145 km, mostly made up of nitrogen and oxygen, which support life on Earth. Mental
part. Atmosphere tidak, Ari. Atmosphere yang kita belajar only for crust, mental the outer core and inner core. Okay, atmosphere ni pun betul juga. Di atmosfera, lapisan surround the earth, dia ada oksigen, which is support the life on the earth. Okay. Kalau hydrosphere ni the water on or the surface of the earth, including ocean, lake, river, rain and mist. Hydro means water. Okay. Kalau atmosphere, dia oksigen, dia udara. Okay. Okay, thank you, Ari.
Teacher,
Ari, teacher. Teacher, share screen.
Oh, benda tu.
Teacher, tak berapa nampak lah yang tulisan kuning tu, yang tajuk tu.
Inner core.
Cuba pergi dekat options. Lepas tu pergi dekat zoom ratio. Lepas tu besarkan. Tekan 300.
Teacher dah hantar.
Check your work. Semua orang dah hantar kat Google Classroom?
Belum.
Dah.
Okay, yang dah tu
je. Nak buat.
Okay, tak apa. Take your time. Allah. Turn in. Muiz eh?
Teacher, may I go to the toilet, please?
Okay, 1 minute. All right, I got your work. How about others? Are you okay? Ari kan dah siap hantar je lah terus. Tak payah tangguh-tangguh lagi. Kena tambah lagi. Ari. Siapa lagi dah finish? I got okay, Raudah dah hantar. Let me see. Mariam Turaya, Roda, please write down your name. This name is, okay, yang hantar tu, macam biasalah, tulis nama you. Kalau nama mak ayah you, I tak kenal lah. Roda Syamimi. Okay, I got it. Ya, boleh tak nak hantar kat Telegram? Hantar dekat Google Classroom lah senang. Kenapa tu Dani? You tak, you ni ke? Tak boleh buka Google Classroom ke macam mana? Okay. Okay, student. Finish?
Yang ni, mesti yang macam kalau yang kejurus.
Okay, tak saya punya tu.
Okay, dapat Muiz. Teacher dah dapat. Kita teacher share sekejap. Mana ni, ya. Okay, yang dah hantar 2%.
Tengah hantar, cik.
Siapa hari dah hantar
lah? Okay, teacher. Saya nak hantar ni.
Okay, very good. Semua orang bagus. Sekejap. Teacher check sekejap.
Teacher dapat ya?
Siapa tu?
Ari.
Sekejap. For Rauf. Class work. Nama you? Ari. Only 2% je ni? Buka.
Cik, ni saya Muhammad Faizal dah.
Saya tu siapa?
Muhammad Zubam Shah. Ijayan Yusuf tu mak saya.
Hamsyah. Cik tak tahu sebab nama student cik tak ada. Juliana Yusuf. Hamsyah ya.
Zubam Shah. Bukan Hamsyah.
Okay. Okay, get it. Okay, thank you. Submission from Zuma. Okay, thank you. I got it. Thank you. I got your work.
So untuk
kena sediakan
macam
tertib
hari
pertama tu. Macam mudah-mudah seorang lagi
siapa
ni?
Muhammad
Faizal.
Ari. Ari.
Teacher.
Ya. Ya saya. Eh, Arik, why you tak send satu slide tu yang you buat tadi?
Macam mana nak send satu slide tu?
Tak boleh kan?
Tak tahu.
Ambil gambar satu-satu, teacher boleh buat kat paint ke? Boleh.
Ambil gambar satu-satu.
Ya, ambil gambar satu-satu kalau saya buat kat PowerPoint.
Sebab kalau tak, kalau tidak, teacher nampak yang ni je lah. Yang lain-lain teacher tak nampak. Okay, we almost running out of time. Thank you very much. Those are submit to me. Those are not submit to me. Submit. After you finish. Okay, I give you time until you can see the deadline. I give it Google Classroom. Okay, what's the class monitor?
Thank you, teacher Azarina.
Thank you, teacher
Azarina. You're welcome. Thank you for joining my class today. Let me say, Surah Al-An, Surah Tasbih Kafara. Amin. Okay, thank you, student.
Bye.
Bye.
Teacher.
Bye.
Bye. Bye. Bye.